I ain't got time for this.
You must be damn stupid if you think you can come back here.
Hello, welcome.
Tom's ma threw him out. She says she'd rather keep the dog.
I need a ticket, please.
You'll find the show in either of the doors beside me.
Folks, I'm going to tell you a morality tale from when our country was young that the settlers used to tell about the woods of Massachusetts and the creatures that lived there. One summer, a bear was by the stream, and Old Man Wind appeared and said, "Bear, I shall blow a mighty cold upon the land. Engorge yourself on fish and meat and go find a den. Then sleep, not for one night, but for 60. Go tell all the animals of the forest what I have told you." Bear was sad because the fish were his friends, and now he had to eat them. But he knew to do whatever the wind told him. The animals of the forest often teased Bear and said he was slow and lazy and foolish for listening to Old Man Wind. "You're talking to the wind again, eh?" laughed the rabbit. "I think Bear has finally taken leave of his senses," said the turtle, "and he's getting so rotund that even I could outrun him."
"I'm smart and quick," said Rabbit. "I'll outrun Old Man Wind if he comes a-calling, or you, since you're into eating your friends."
The turtle said, "If Wind comes, I'll just hide in my shell." Then Bear went and warned Coyote and Possum that they should prepare for a long, cold winter. "It's so hot," said the coyote. "There's plenty of time." The lazy possum said, "Well, there's an abundance of food. Maybe I'll just store some in my pouch." Even his squirrel friends made fun of Bear. They laughed and laughed and squibbled and squabbled.
"Chunky needs a nap. Fatty Goody Two-Shoes does what he's told."
Bear was very sad. But he was a good bear, and he always did what Old Man Wind told him. He went and found a den, snuggled inside, and fell fast asleep. Bear snored and snored for many days. When he woke up, he saw spring had come. He was very hungry, so he walked outside. As the snow melted, he saw all his friends who hadn't listened, frozen and just ready to be eaten. And that's why the bear hibernates. So listen to your elders and do just what you're told.
Come back for another one.